I'm Remy, and I identify, it's changed a lot, but I really identify as female to male, FTM.
So my name's Nate, I identify as a trans man.
Hi, I'm Julie Peters, and most people would think of me as trans, but I don't really think of myself as trans. I think of myself as just a person, but I understand that most people see me as a woman.
A common misconception is that all trans people are the same. Trans people are, well, people. They all have their wants and their needs and their own identities.
It's a common misconception about the link between mental health and mental illness and being trans and gender diverse. For me, I don't think that the issues that I've had in the past with depression and anxiety haven't been so much around my gender identity, and it's more around other life stuff like work. I finally sort of found people that, you know, health providers that get that, and that they don't necessarily think that, oh, okay, so you're trans, so let's talk about that as being your issue, is why you're in distress at the moment.
I think a lot of the misconceptions people have about trans people is based on the fact that they've seen some stereotypes, or they've seen some movie, or they've met one or two people. Most people believe that we live in a world that there are only two types of people, men and women, and the gender those people perform is based on their biology.
I don't need to have a penis to be a guy.
I find if you really have to ask me a question, if it's something specific that you don't, to me, that you want to know, don't just kind of just shout it out in front of like a bunch of other people. Just be like, oh yeah, but like, what junk do you have? Or like, can you grow a penis and that kind of stuff? But if it's something like, but like, what is trans? Like whatever, and then like Google it, man.
I think I got very lucky that my parents just, yeah, it doesn't really faze them. When I came out as a lesbian initially, they were kind of unfazed. And then when I came out as trans, they were unfazed. The only thing is my mum's sort of jokes a little bit about like what's going to happen next. But yeah, so they just like me as a person, which is kind of nice.
I grew up in a time where there was no real advice about gender nonconformity. But my first concept of gender nonconformity came from Shakespeare, reading Twelfth Night in high school. And all of a sudden there was the boy actors playing a woman who then disguises herself as a boy. And I went, wow, this is amazing.
People that gave me really good advice were either on YouTube or Tumblr. Basically just when they said what they were doing and how what they experienced, kind of like seeing them go through a process and them actually doing it and knowing they're like not that different to you, that you could do it, was really, really inspiring.
I think if I had to give advice to someone, it would be that were having questions about their gender, it would be take your time. When I decided I wanted to transition, I wanted to do everything right then and there and wanted to be in a hurry, but actually taking the time to think about things, I was more prepared to do it because I was more, I don't know, settled, I suppose, within myself.
One of the guys at work said to me, you ought to have transsexual tattooed on your forehead so blokes like me aren't tricked into being profiters. When you get a lot of discrimination and vilification thrown your way, it can really, really wear you down. You know, it's that old saying, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. But the trouble is, a lot of people don't make it. I had just enough self-esteem to get through that. About 5 years later, he said to me, well, it's not so much that you change, but you forced me to change. And I went, oh, wow, that's amazing.
Best thing about being trans is, I guess, I have more empathy for women. You get to, like, it's control. Like, you choose if you go through another puberty. And you get to learn a lot about yourself.
I think everything about being trans is positive, to be honest. I like the fact that I've sort of been able to see into different worlds. Yeah, I love the fact that I'm trans. It's fantastic.
I think the most positive thing about being trans is internal. It's just about being me and being, I can relax. I'm far more comfortable in my own skin today than I've ever been in my whole life before.